So now let's understand the last variant of the VRE, that is DAPRE, that is daily adjustable progressive resistance exercise. In this regime, the resistance is adjusted on the daily basis, that is daily adjustable working weight we are going to decide, and that's why it is decided daily and adjusted daily. That's why the name came is the daily adjustable progressive resisted exercise. What happens in this regime? Here also you are going to have four sets of repetitions of the movement. In the first set, you are going to give 10 repetitions. With here you are using the resistance as a 6 RM. In the previous three of the techniques, we have used 10 RM. And in reference to 10 RM, we were increasing or reducing the weight, or we are keeping the same. Here we are taking 6 RM, and according to that we are having the regime here. So in the first set, it is 10 repetition with half of the 6 RM. Then in the second set, 6 repetition with 3/4 of 6 RM. In the third set, maximum possible repetition with complete full 6 RM. And in the fourth repetition, fourth set, we have maximum possible repetition with the adjustable working weight. Now the question arises that how we are going to calculate this adjusted working weight. So this adjusted working weight will be dependent on number of repetitions which the patient can do in the third set, and depending on that number of set, we have the whole tabular form which decides that what to do with this 6 RM, whether to increase or reduce in the coming next fourth set. So we will get this adjusted working weight depending on the repetition. This will be able to have a clear idea with a example. So let's take the same example of 20 kg. Okay. So here it's not 10 RM. Here the patient's 6 RM is 20 kg. Okay. 6 RM is 20 kg. Okay. In the 20 pound, with the 20 pound, when you want to give the first set, it is 10 repetition with half of the 6 RM. That means 10 pound. Then in the second set, 6 repetition with 3/4, that is 75% of the 6 RM. That is going to be 15 pound. And the third set, maximum possible repetition, whatever amount of the repetition patient can perform with the full 6 RM, that is 20 kg. Okay, and this number of repetition will decide that in the fourth set, what amount of resistance we want to give to the patient. Suppose your patient has performed one or two repetition only with the 6 RM, then what you are going to do with this 6 RM, that is 20 kg, to get your adjusted working weight? Here you have the whole table. Now when you look at the table, repetition in the set 3, if it is 0 to 2, either patient could not perform with the complete 6 RM, or patient has done one or two repetition with the in the third set with the 6 RM, that is 20 kg. Then for the set 4, you are going to reduce the resistance by 5 to 10 kg. That means it is 20 kg. Now you can reduce it by 5 to 10 kg. That is either 15 or 13 kg. You can have as a weight which the patient will lift in the adjusted weight. So here, if the repetition is 0 to 2, then my adjusted weight would be in the fourth repetition, here is 15 kg. Okay, because I have reduced by 5 to 10, 15, or depending on the patient's capacity, you can keep it either 15 or 12 or 13 kg. Okay, so this is for example 0 to 2. Likewise, you can decide if the repetition is 5 to 6 in the set 3. Then in the set 4, I am going to have keep it the same. So I am going to have the same 20 kg as in adjusted working weight, and I am going to ask the patient to do maximum repetition which the patient can do with that 20 kg, which is the adjusted weight, because the patient has performed 5 to 6 repetition only in the third set. Okay, and likewise, if the patient has performed 11 or more, suppose patient has performed 13 repetition with the 6 RM. So then in the next fourth set, you are going to increase the weight by 5 to 10 kg. So here, adding to the 20 kg, you have added 7, then it will come to 27 LV. So here the adjusted working rate would be 20 LV. So patient in the fourth set going to perform maximum possible repetition with 27 pound weight. Okay. So this is how you can have the adjusted working weight. And depending on this adjusted working weight, you can decide the next day's 10 RM. So in the next day, depending on the set 3 you are going to, next day that 6 RM might reduce, because in the third session the patient could perform only 0 to 2. So that's why you in the set 4 you have reduced from that 6 RM 5 to 10 pound, and on the next day the very first 20 LV would be getting reduced by 0 to 5 LV. Either you will keep it 20 or you will start as in 6 RM from 15 pound only. Likewise, depending on the repetition, keep it same or increase by 0 to 5, increase by 5 to 10 or increase by 15 to 20. Okay, so once you are going to refer the book, you are going to have the table in front of you, and any of the example, as we have took 6 RM and 20 LV here. So if you are going to take any example and you are going to keep the figures, you will understand that how you are calculating the adjusted working weight and the weight for the next 2 days. Thank you.